My name is Joanne Schrempf, and I'm a member of St. Genevieve Catholic Church, and I would like to welcome all of you to our World Day of Prayer. A little bit of information before we begin. You should all have a program, and you should all have a that we will use later on in the service. A little bit of information about this program. It's an abbreviated form of the program that you will see today. And it might be a little bit confusing because you may or may not realize when you are supposed to respond. So what we're going to do is, at the beginning of each section, for example, the first section is introduction and invitation to worship. The person who is going to be speaking next will give that information, will give that title. And then the last person to speak in that section, right before you are to respond, will lift her arm so that you know that's a signal for you to respond. Okay? At this time, I would like to introduce Father Dennis Schmidt, who's the pastor of St. Genevieve Catholic Church, to welcome you and give us a blessing.
Yes, I'm Father Dennis, and I could also give a word of welcome here to Knights of Columbus Hall. I'm not only a pastor of St. Genevieve Catholic Church, but also a member here at Knights of Columbus. So I'm going to welcome this day of prayer. Let's, since a little bit odd, but I think it's good to us to give a little blessing upon our day, morning of taking some time for prayer. Lord, ask a blessing upon this time of prayer. May it be time to just really give glory and honor to you. Help us to be united in one through your Spirit. Be upon us and guide us throughout this morning. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen. Introduction and invitation to worship. Welcome to this World Day of Prayer service, prepared by the World Day of Prayer Committee of Egypt. Egypt is the scene of many Bible stories, including the one of Pharaoh's daughter, who dared to contradict her father's command by rescuing the infant Moses from drowning. As an infant, when Jesus was threatened by Herod's infanticide, Egypt was a safe place of refuge for him and his family.
Christianity has its roots in Egypt. It was St. Mark who organized the first Egyptian church and established the first theological school, from which graduated many of the great Christian thinkers. Today, the church in Egypt is still strong. World Day of Prayer is a wonderful celebration for Egyptian families each year on the first Friday of March.
We invite you to pray with us before God, whose love and mercy flows among us like dreams in the desert.
Hear, O God, hear our voices from the desert in our lives.
Prayer of Confession. If we say we are without sin, we lie and the truth is not in us. But if we admit our sins, God, the faithful and just one, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all injustice. Will you join me in reading the prayer of confession?
Almighty God, we confess that we have sinned against you and against one another in many ways, sometimes through negligence, other times through weakness or stubbornness. We confess our intolerance and disregard of our neighbors. We are truly sorry and repent of all these things, whether intentional or not. As people of faith, we want to transform our repentance into the prayer of our actions, to be like trees by the flowing streams. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your great and precious name. Amen.
Assurance of forgiveness. May God pour on us the water of forgiveness, and grant us peace.
Thus says God, your maker, your helper, who formed you in the womb.
Do not be afraid, for I will pour water on the thirsty land and streams on the dry ground.
I will pour out my spirit on your offspring and my blessing on your descendants.
St. Joseph's School in Zell and myself will lead us in the congregational hymn. Please join, "Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing."
We praise the Lord for the amazing civilization of ancient Egypt and for the extraordinary action of the River Nile that created the fertile soil upon which it was built. We are proud of our ancient, awe-inspiring monuments. Two of them were among the seven wonders of the ancient world. Today, the three Giza pyramids still stand, a testament to their builders' search for a deeper meaning to this life and to their hope for a richer life after death. God of wonder, both past and present,
we admire the wisdom that has discovered in history and in the ways that brings people together.
I live in a small village in today's Egypt and know how to manage with little I have. In the village, we women do a lot to provide for the family through farming, feeding the animals, making cheese and yogurt, and baking large loaves of flat bread. I have recently learned how to read. Most of my neighbors go to the mosque on Fridays. There is no church in our village, so on Sunday, I go with my family to a church in a nearby town. We thank and praise the Lord for the River Nile and its lakes. It flows from Central Africa, watering our fields, quenching our thirst, and providing us with plenty of fish to eat. The second longest river in the world, it unites us with people of other countries and different cultures. Its running water symbolizes the living water offered by Jesus to all of us. God of wonder, both past and present.
We celebrate the river that waters across the Euro.
contemporary Egyptian citizen working in a government job in Cairo, the capital of Egypt. I work for the Ministry of Agriculture, and my department is engaged in reclaiming the desert. Today, much desert land is blooming with colorful plants. As a single woman, I can devote more time to my church, one of the numerous Coptic Orthodox churches in Egypt. The Coptic Orthodox Church goes back to the first century. In Egypt, there are many Christian churches of different denominations. In Cairo alone, there are over 200 churches. We praise the Lord for our unity in Christ, for our freedom to worship, and for our opportunities to work in government and private sectors. God of wonder, both past and present,
we rejoice that the desert land is blossoming in the living colors, and that the churches are striving for unity in Christ.
Young woman living in this wonderful electronic age, the age of iPods, Skype, Facebook, and cell phones. In Egypt, like everywhere else, there are rich people and poor people. There's also the middle class, to which I belong. Like many others of my generation, I'm fluent in three languages, Arabic, English, and French. Some of my friends are fluent in German as well. Our educational opportunities make it possible for us young people to plan and successfully carry out our demonstrations that took place on January 25th, 2011. It's exciting for all of us, both Christian and Muslim, to come together to Tahrir Square and successfully claim our right to freedom, justice, and equality. Although many things have happened since then, we keep reminding ourselves of God's promise to Isaiah, blessed be Egypt and our people. God of wonder, both present and past.
Thank you. Bible story adapted from John 4, 3 through 42. Jesus left Judea and started back to Galilee. In order to get there, he had to go through Samaria. So he came to a town in Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of the ground of Jacob that had given his son, Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired as he was from the journey, sat down by the well. It was about noon. As he sat there, a Samaritan woman came to draw water.
Will you give me a drink?
You are a Jew, and I am a Samaritan woman. How can you ask me for a drink?
If you knew the gift of God and who it is who is asking you for a drink, you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water.
Sir, I'm just noticing that you have no bucket, and the well is deep. Excuse me if I'm being rude, but where are you going to get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the well and drank from it himself, as did also his sons and his flocks and his herds?
Everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water that I will give will never thirst. Indeed, the water that I will give you will become a spring of water within you, gushing up for eternal life.
Sir, give me this water so that I won't get thirsty and have to keep coming here to draw water.
Go call your husband and come back.
I have no husband.
Indeed, you do not have a husband, it is true, for you have had five husbands. And the man that you're living with now is not your husband. So what you have said is true enough.
Sir, I can see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worshipped on this mountain, but you claim that the place where we must worship is in Jerusalem. Who is right?
Believe me, a time is coming when you will worship God neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. Time is coming when, in fact, it's already here, when true worshipers will worship God in spirit and truth. Indeed, it is such just worshipers that God sees. God is spirit, and those who worship God must worship in spirit and truth.
Well, either way, I know that the Messiah is coming. I'm sure the Messiah will explain everything to us.
I who speak to you am the Messiah.
You, the Messiah?
Then leaving her water jar, the woman went back to the town and said to the people,
come, a man who told me everything I ever did. Could this be the Messiah?
Well, when they heard that everyone left town to meet Jesus, many of the Samaritans from that town believed in him because of what the woman said to them. So when the Samaritans met him, they urged him to stay with them. He stayed with them for 2 days, and because of his words, no longer does our faith depend on your story. We've heard up for ourselves, and we know that this really is the Savior of the world. Praise God.
As a young woman in Egypt, I am inspired by how the Samaritan's dialogue at the well impacted her whole community. I'm a myself saw a similar change within my community. Not at a well, but at a gathering in Tiberias Square. The Samaritan woman's conversation with Jesus went deeper and deeper until there are no more barriers between them. The conversation began with who was wrong and right, and moved giving and receiving the living water of life. This is how it felt to get to know my Muslim brothers and sisters as we stood together for God's justice in the square.
Listen to this. In Hebrew, the word for well is the same as the word for to see. I can imagine myself by the well looking down at the water. The water is like a mirror. I can see not only myself, but if I look closer, I can see the whole world. I can see streams forming in the desert. I can see Jesus offering this living water. And I can see young people and women gladly receiving it and bringing it back to their communities. I can see them offering this living water to all they encounter. I can see God transforming deserts of desolation, destruction, and despair into streams of just, restoring, living water through us.
What if we begin our own conversation with the well? Either the well we have here now or later on our cell phones and social networks. We now invite you to come forward with the stone you were given when you entered and drop it in the river, the bowl of water on the table. While doing so, say a sign of prayer for others here today who will also be dropping their stones in the living water. Then please return to your seats.
Stone. Bring your stone. Just walk up row by row.
Friday in March and the following weekend, women around the world give to the World Day of Prayer offering. This money is collected by national committees and is used to perpetuate the work of World Day of Prayer, including worship services like this one. The offerings are also used to fund grants to organizations working on issues that affect women and children, both in the United States and worldwide. We have one of those organizations in St. Louis called Lydia House. They receive a grant for medical and transportation to support those women that are escaping domestic violence. You can also look for more information about World Day of Prayer and the grants on the internet. We ask you to give generously now in faith that the God who provides living water will turn our dollars and cents into streams in the desert for others. If you would like to receive tax credit for your donation, please write a personal check with your correct address indicated. And as the offering is being collected, we will enjoy the talents of the children from St. Joseph and their leader, Patty Knagger.
Intercession. O God, according to your promises, hear our prayer. Help us become the ones who fulfill your promises as recorded in Isaiah. May we treasure the water that you give us so we can use it responsibly and sustainably. Make us sensitive to places stricken by poverty and by natural disasters, whether in Egypt or in other parts of the world, that we may join in efforts to seek to relieve their distress. We join our voices to call for living water.
Hear us, O Lord.
We pray for our fellow women in Egypt. Egypt and in all other countries, as women are usually among the first to suffer when the economy is bad. Especially, we pray for widows everywhere. Make us sensitive to their needs. May we seek to quench their thirst and to help them find water in parched areas. We join our voices to call for living water.
Hear us, O Lord.
We pray for increased interest in and funding for education, especially the education of girls. May we use your own gifts graciously bestowed upon us to bring this about, thus enabling all people to play a more constructive role in their societies. We join our voices to call for living water.
Hear us, O Lord.
Grant us the spirit of self-giving love, forgiveness, and generosity, and remove from us all selfishness, so that we might become channels of your living water to the world. We join our voices to call for living water.
Hear us, O Lord.
Amen.
And our song, our closing song, is She Would Trust in Me. You probably don't know it, but it is a very easy song. Once we sing it, learn, you'll get it, and then join in clapping as well.
She would trust in me from her deep inside.
I will pour water on the thirsty land
and streams on the dry ground.
I will pour out my spirit on your offspring
and my blessing on your descendants.
This is what the Lord says.
Please stand and extend your right hand to give this beautiful blessing. All together, may God
always guide you. Even when you meet in desert places, may God give strength to your bones and make you like a watered garden, like a spring of water whose waters never run dry.
Please stand.
I would like to thank all of you for coming this morning, and for Father Dennis and the Church of St. Genevieve for hosting. And I also would like to thank the participating churches, the Church of St. Genevieve, First Presbyterian Church, First Baptist Church, Hope Church, St. Joseph's Catholic Church, and Remnant Church. Thank all of you who helped plan and set up. And I would like to extend a special thank you to Jackie Brillos for the beautiful props and artwork that she created for us today. And also for Patty Nager and the Children of St. Joseph's School for the wonderful music. And I invite all of you to eat and enjoy the refreshments that were provided by the Church of St. Genevieve and the First Presbyterian Church. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.